Hello everyone, and welcome to this atelier number 3 of the Big Data and AI Paris 2021. First, I would like to thank the organizers for this amazing opportunity of being here today. I'm Ariel Ibaba, and I'm acting as the lead of the AI and Data Science Initiative to Activian, and I will have the pleasure to be presenting this workshop. Our use case is about implementing an AI-based solution to assess the risk of COVID-19 contamination and raise alert in real time. To achieve that, we will be using images from cameras, a deep learning model to perform face mask detection in real time. Also, we will be using our platform Atoti to first process the result of the detections of the model in real time and implement the calculation of sanitary indicators. Finally, we will monitor the evolution of these sanitary indicators in real time and raise an alert whenever predefined thresholds are crossed. Now let's move on to the architecture of the solution to give you an overview of how it works. The application is composed of two main modules, a deep learning based one and an Atoti one. First, when the images from the cameras pass through the deep learning module, face mask detections are performed in real time, and the result of the detections are stored in a dedicated folder. Then this folder is monitored constantly by a watchdog application to identify any new data in and allow the Atoti app to upload this data and perform post-processing calculation in real time. Into the Atoti module, calculations are performed and the results are pushed into the Atoti app in the form of visualization to make it available to anyone in real time. Now let's move deeper in understanding the functioning of our solution. Let's consider first the mask face detection module. As explained previously, this module is based on deep learning. Also, I need to precise that our use case is clearly an object detection one, as the objective is to be able to detect faces with or without mask from images. We decided to follow the implementation from Detectron 2 framework by Facebook AI research. For the simplicity of the implementation, the clarity of the documentation and the tutorials. Among all the detectors tested from this framework, we retain the faster RCNN model as the best performing one, and we fine-tune this model on a custom dataset. Also, I need to admit that this is the part where we struggled a little bit to reach especially the performance level we were expecting at the very beginning, especially because of the quality of the training dataset that we got from Kaggle. So I will be happy to discuss with you the outcome of this part, the lesson that we learned, and how we managed to create a custom dataset and to improve our model and to get satisfying results. So don't hesitate to reach me after this presentation to discuss especially on this part. Now, let's see in real time how our system performs. We will load a video issued from a camera selected randomly. Here, it's a camera located in New York that we choose for this demo. This camera shows people walking in New York City in the street. Some of them wear masks and others are not wearing masks. So we will see in real time how our system performs the light detection. So now the model is loaded and the camera is being read. We will see the frame. Now we can see here the detections in real time in the street. So here the video has been a little bit accelerated to skip some frames. You can see the light detection of our model. I will let the video run for a while to be able to assess the performance of the model.
You can see here that even the image of the girl in the publicity is being detected as not wearing your mask. Here we see the people in different angles. Some of them are facing the camera and the detections are easy. For others in different angle, appearing in different angles, the detection are still being performed well. Okay. You can see that the detections are not bad at all with associated probabilities, so people without mask and with mask, with the confidence level of the prediction. Here we can see this guy on the left wearing a mask incorrectly. He's detected not wearing a mask. This is made on purpose. This is the way we train the model to detect people not wearing a mask correctly as not having a mask. So we have two classes only, with mask or without mask. Knowing that with mask is when the mask is being worn correctly. It's a case also with this guy here on the right, who's wearing a mask, but not correctly because we can see his nose. So it is detecting as not wearing a mask. Again, we can see it, he has no mask. Let's continue a little bit, see more people. This video is very long, so we will not run it completely. It's just to show you in different situations with different luminosity, how the model works. Capturing people with different angles. Again, here we can see detections. Okay, I think I can stop the video here. We have seen how the model works. So later we can discuss on the how we built this model, how we built the custom data set to reach the performing level that we were expecting at the very beginning.
Now, let's talk about the second module of our application, which is used to post-process the result of the detection and raise an alert. This module is based on our platform Atoti, which is a collaborative tool which can be used from any Python notebook. Atoti combines a powerful data aggregation engine and a data visualization platform. The aggregation engine uses multidimensional and what-if analysis natively and allows you to deal with huge volume of data in milliseconds. For example, you can process millions of rows on a computer using it, or terabytes of data in the cloud. The Data Web application allows you to share your analysis via advanced interactive dashboard available via a simple link. Anybody receiving the link can access the dashboards and customize them depending on their needs. Using these features in Atoti requires just a few lines of code, which makes Atoti a very effective tool and easy to use. Now, let's see in details what we implement in Atoti. We aggregate the result of the detections and enrich them with government data corresponding to the incident rate in departments in France. Also, we implement the calculation of the risk of COVID-19 contamination issued from COVID tracker website. This calculation takes as an input an incidence rate and the number of people observed and returns the probability of having at least one person infected with COVID-19 within this population. Finally, we define custom thresholds corresponding to critical probability of COVID-19 infection risk and proportion of people not wearing a mask. And we implement an alerting system that is triggered anytime the observations exceed these predefined thresholds. Here, all the outputs are available in dashboards, updating in real time. Now, let's see a live demo of our application using Atoty. Here, I will showcase our application on my personal laptop on a Jupyter notebook with the data locally. I will run the application locally, knowing that this is totally feasible in a cloud environment. So I will first load all the necessary libraries, define all the required paths to the data, to the model, to the videos also that we will be reading in real time, and to perform detections. I'll pass the details of implementation of utility function to send the alert to get the video and process the names of the video. This is the first part that is important here, where we create a session. To use Atoty, you need to first define a session. And one of the configuration parameters, which is very important, is to define the location where you want to store the dashboard that you will be creating in this session. And then later, you will share this dashboard with the link to your colleagues. So you need to define this location first. So I will run this part. It could take some seconds depending on your machine. Then here we create the table in which we will append all the detection results. Also, we load the table containing the details of the cameras and their location, the city. We upload here the government data containing the incidence rate on the different departments in France, which is available in their website, www.data.gouv.fr. Then here we join the different table and we create our cube. This is the most critical part of the analysis, the most important. Everything in Atoty is loaded into a cube, which is stored in the active memory, which allows later calculation to be very fast to access the result in milliseconds. So this is the in-memory calculation in Atoty. This is particular, this is specific in the implementation of Atoty. So here we can observe all the tables that we have that have been loaded into the Atoty cube. We can see the table with the result of the detections in real time, the table containing the ID of the video and their location, and then the table containing the incidence rate in the different departments of France. This will allow us, by crossing all this data, to then calculate the probability of getting infected with Atoty, which takes into account the incidence rate and the number of people at a given location. We have the camera IDs in this table and the location of the camera here, and we can retrieve the incidence rate for a given location in the government data here. So this is a very interesting feature in Atoty, the cube schema, that allows you to visualize quickly all the data, the table that you ingested in the Atoty cube for your analysis. Now let's focus on our alerting system, which relies on two conditions. One is about the proportion of people not wearing a mask within a population observed, and the other is about the probability of having at least one person infected with COVID-19 within this population. For each of these criteria, we define specific thresholds. Here we consider arbitrarily two situations depending on the size of the population. We distinguish the case where we have a population of 5 people or less from the situation where we observe a population of more than 5 people. In each case, we define a specific critical proportion of people without mask. And we consider also a probability threshold of 5% for the COVID tracker risk, being the risk of having at least one people infected with COVID-19 within the population observed. Here, an alert is raised anytime the two thresholds are exceeded simultaneously. In the following part here, we will calculate all the quantities and the measures required for the calculation of the risk of contamination and all the conditions to trigger to raise an alert. Let's stop to this first feature, session doc visualize, which allows us to visualize different quantities calculated in ATOT. Here on the left panel, if I select here the cell where I create this visualization, I can see that I can manipulate easily this widget, changing, for example, the type of visualization. Here it's a pivot table. I can, for example, choose a different representation, stick areas, or even. So this is totally interactive in ATOT. You can play, I can drag and drop any dimension hierarchies in X axis or Y that I want to visualize. This is one of the amazing features in ATOT, and it requires just one line of code. All the rest is interactive. I can play with this visualization, change, select any type of visualization that I want, and play with the different values. In the following part, we define all the measures that we want, so the different proportions of unmasked people. Here we implement the calculation of the COVID tracker risk. This formula is available on their website. And we create the risk measure. So I will paste past all this detail. And here is the watchdog part, where we create an observer to monitor in real time the update of the dedicated location where we store all the detections in real time. And here with this comment session doc link, we can decide to store, to save in fact all the visualization created previously in a dashboard available with just this link. I can click on this link to see the available visualization right now. Now, if I go back to the notebook, I will create a detector. So I will instantiate our model that performs the detections in real time from the cameras. And I will add a new video source. I define this function that allows me to add a new video. I will add a new camera that will connect to our solution, which is camera located in Paris, camera number 5. I play it live. So now it is loading the model. The model is being loaded. And the video, the camera is starting, the system is starting to read the images from the camera in real time. Now, if I go back to the dashboard, I will be able to visualize in real time the result from this new camera that I added in the system. I will refresh first my dashboard here. And normally, I'm able to observe now the camera number 5, which is available, located in Paris. And I can observe the prediction here in real time. So we are collecting the data every 5 seconds. This is what you can observe here. Every 5 seconds, the numbers are being updated in real time. And we have the alerting result here. So for each timestamp, in fact, we can see if we raise an alert or not. True or false. In real time again. Then if I go back to the notebook, I will be able to add a third camera if I want. Here, for example, to achieve that, I will play in parallel a different video with a different notebook. I pass you the detail of loading the model. I will play, for example, the camera number 7, located in Mayotte, and we will be able normally in real time to see the result displaying in our Atuty dashboard in real time. We run everything here and run our camera. So the model is being loaded, the weight, the trend model. And here we can see also that the video is being read. So first, I will make sure that, just to show you, that the results are from the new video are not available yet. If I go to data output file, I can see now that only the result of detections for the two first camera are available, the camera 1 and camera 5 from Paris. Now the new file is created with the result of the detection of camera 7 available now. So if we go back to our dashboard to check this result in real time, you can see that video 7 is available with the location Mayotte. We select it and then we can visualize the detections in real time as previously for the camera number 5 from Paris. So here again we can see the timestamp changing, the result updating every 10 or 5 seconds with the alarm situation, the alarm status being changed in real time. Now we arrive at the end of this presentation. Thank you again for your attention. If you want to know more about Atuty and the different features, please feel free to visit our website atuty.io. You will find also a series of articles available in our website, Medium article on Medium, on our Medium. Also on our GitHub, you will find different notebooks corresponding to similar use cases, demonstrating how you can use Atuty with machine learning, data science approach. So feel free, if you have any question, to reach us and to try Atuty, and the community will be always available to answer your questions about Atuty. Thank you very much.